Welcome. This would be our expected question series for 2019. The first session that we would start with is environment, a very important topic these days. And this topic is a big topic, so we'll be having 2-3 sessions on environment. Now, the first environmental news that's really into news and is very, very important is Academic Lomonosov. Now, this is the world's first floating nuclear power plant which has become operational with the help of Russia, and it's basically the Russian Atomic Energy Corporation, which is known as Rostom. So Rostom, the name is important. Under whom it has been named? So it has been named under Russian academician Michael Lomonosov. It is also known as Nuclear Titanic or the Chernobyl on ice. So those names are again important for this question. The next type of questions that could come up would be the conservation projects, the various conservation projects. Asiatic Lion is one of those, very, very important. Who launched this project? That's a kind of common question. So this has been under Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. The idea is to conserve the Asiatic lions and develop the ecosystem with them. So this would be funded under a centrally sponsored scheme with the development of wildlife habitat, which is also known as DWH. The cost would be, as usual for all projects, 60-40, 60 by center, 40 by the state. Now, very important thing is Asiatic lion has been put up under the category of endangered species under the IUCN classification. We have covered a separate video on IUCN classification, so you can just have the links and refer that. The predominant area where you have this species is the state of Gujarat. The population has increased over the areas, and the most important regions are the Gir National Park, the Gir Sanctuary. You have Pania Sanctuary, Mithila Sanctuary, and the adjoining regions. So that's one of the most important aspects. Similarly, you have olive riddle turtles. Now, olive riddle turtle, you have two major nesting sites. One is the Gahirmatha National Site, and the next is the Rushikulya rockery. Besides this, you also have the Badhua rockery. That's again important. Among all the turtles, olive riddle is considered as the smallest and the most abundant of those. You also have their unique nesting phenomena where all the female turtles come up together, which is known as aribada, which is again an important term, mainly seen in the warm waters of Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean. So those are some of the highlights about olive riddle. Olive riddle turtles, very, very important for your examination point of view. Now, India has to submit the second biennial report on greenhouse gas inventory. This is again important. Now, India, since being a party to UNFCCC, needs to submit the mitigation and the various information reports. So the standards and the emission standards, or the emissions released in 2014, have been brought up. So there are 5 components under which this report has been discussed. That's very, very important. So a direct question could be, which of the following is not a component of the greenhouse gas inventory report being submitted by India? And then you have certain statistics that's here. So the 5 aspects are very, very important. The next is Parivesh. Very important concept. First of all, the acronym is important. So it's proactive and responsive facilitation by interactive, virtuous, environmental, single window hub. So you have all the workflow applications that have been developed online. The submissions have been done online. You have the entire proposal, including the online submission updating, which would be done on a single platform. And this single platform would provide clearance monitoring as well as all documentation that's required for it. So all pendency cases could be cleared up. There would be a decrease in the reduction time for processing these concepts. So that's something that's very, very important for environmental clearances. The things that used to have or consume a lot of time would now be consolidated under one single hub. And that's why this Parivesh is important. So sometimes you have similar questions. You have Parivesh, you have the sachet being released by RBI recently. So that's again important. Not related to environment, we'll cover that in economics. The next is panel on world, on the Western Ghats. Western Ghats is one of the hotspots of the world. Again, you have numerous flora and fauna that have been found in this area. Two important committees with respect to Western Ghats, Madhav Gadkil committee, and you have K. Kasturirangan committee. The idea is this Western Ghats region is an ESA, ecologically sensitive area, and there are no-go zones that have been demarcated. That means no construction activities, non-polluting activities, no deforestation would be allowed in these areas. So that's again something that has been important. India has been constantly taking efforts to reduce the carbon footprints or the carbon emissions from the farming. Now, some of the important efforts that have been done is neem-coated urea. That is one of those. You already had a question on neem-coated urea 2 years back, so that's important. Similarly, you have system of rice intensification. You have Krishi Vikas Yojana, Green Revolution to Eastern India. You have the Food Security Mission for India. Zero tillage drill machines have come up. Then organic farming, which is in the name of Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, rain-fed area development project, soil health card schemes, models for integrated farming systems are some of the important aspects. Stubble burning, very, very important and a major cause of air pollution in the North India. So how you can check that is important. So NCR has been highly affected by the stubble burning of the crops in Punjab and Haryana, which causes most of the air pollution as per the Lancet report and a major cause of health problems in that area. National Clean Clean Air Program has been launched. This aims to tackle the increasing rate of pollution in the cities and the towns. Now, what are the expected ideas that have to be met? The plan is for 5 years. That's important. One of the important sections of your MCQ. The next is the target is to reduce to nearly 20-30% of the concentrations of particulate matter 10 and 2.5 by 2024, considering 2017 as a base year. So that's very, very important. So reduction is 20-30%, 5 years program. Nearly 102 non-attainable attainment cities have been part of it, and quality monitoring has been important. Similarly, another very important topic is South Asian Nitrogen Hub. The idea is to control the nitrogen pollution mainly through agriculture in the parts of India and South Asia. The following institutions have tied up. So another question could be, which of the following institution is not party to the South Asian Nitrogen Hub? Again, very, very important, as we already said. So 8 countries which are party to it, the list of those 8 countries and the list of partnering institutes is something that you will have to memorize and really important for your examination. Similarly, on tiger conservation, you have the GTRP, that is Global Tiger Recovery Program. This program is focusing on the tigers across the countries and the wildlife trafficking that is taking place. So transborder as well as within India, you have the preservation that's talked about, and the idea is to double the wild tiger population by 2022. So that's again important. That's by eradicating poaching, checking the wildlife trafficking. The next is World Wetlands Day. It's important to understand that the rate of deforestation has been high, but wetlands have been really, really important because the rate of disappearance for the wetland is 1%, which is much higher than the rate for your deforestation. A recent example in this slide was Nal Sarovar in Gujarat, which has dried up this year. So Ramsar Convention talks about conservation for the wetlands. Similar to wetlands, we also talk about the swamps, the marshy areas, the peatlands, and mitigating the impacts of global warming on those areas. So the climate change, global warming have been a threat, and 2nd February is celebrated as the World Wetlands Day. This year the theme was wetland and climate change. The next is the impact of global warming on El Nino. El Nino itself is very, very important topic. So we have covered a separate class where we have talked about southern oscillations, La Nina and El Nino as a phenomena, how they occur, which parts of the world they affect, and their impacts on the various parts. So that's a very important, a very short video that you have to cover. Important also for your GS purpose. The next is Indian Great Bustard has been considered as a mascot for the convention Conference of Parties for your Convention on Conservation of Migratory Species, which is also known as CMS. Now, CMS is a part of Bonn Convention. Bonn Convention has been headquartered from Bonn in Germany. You have the idea to cover not only the migratory species, which are avian, but also the terrestrial migratory species under this. Great Indian Bustard has been named as the mascot, which is also called as Gibi as a short form. So that's important. Again, a very important part on Convention of Migratory Species, a possible question could be there. India-Norway has tied up on numerous fronts. Most important is curbing the marine pollution, having sustainable waste management practices, and supporting a lot of activities for coastal restoration, beach cleaning. The next is, Environmental Ministry has come up with solutions for climate change. Under this, you have definitely Solar Alliance, the International Solar Alliance, which talks about renewable energy. You have the FAME scheme, which talks about hybrid vehicles, electric vehicles. You also have the Amrit scheme under the urban transformation. We have already talked about Amrit scheme with the smart city mission, so that's important. You have the Ujjwala Yojana for LPG subsidy, Ujjala Yojana for LED bulbs, the Swachh Bharat mission. Also, you have the National Adaptation Fund for climate change, very important. We'll cover a separate lecture on that. Probably a very important topic for this year. Similarly, you have the World Sustainable Development Summit organized in 2019 by TERI. So who organized that? Who was partner to it is important. The idea is to focus more on global issues, bring in long-term solutions and for sustainability. Similarly, you have a pact which has been signed with Canadian universities on research for environment. So this is by the University of British Columbia. The idea is to explore opportunity for the next coming 10 years, mainly in the field of forestry sciences. So forestry sciences, how you can work around that, how you can conserve the forest, prevent the deforestation, better utilization of forest products are some of the major issues that have been addressed. So from India, you have the Wildlife Institute of India based in Dehradun, the Forest Survey of India, the Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy, and so on, which have been a partner to it. Similarly, a very important question is, in Kerala, close to Cochin, the Puthuapi, you have a new campus for Center for Marine Living Resources and Ecology, which has been inaugurated. Now, the idea is to make it under a part of Sagar Sampada cell for implementation of various marine living resources program. So, conserving those resources, developing the ecosystem and energy resources is something that's important. India has banned the import of solid plastic waste, which it used to do so far. So previously, in India, the solid waste was allowed for processing. And of recent, and under the recent amendment of the plastic rules 2016, we have banned the import of plastic waste for the purpose of processing in India. Very important, and this is mainly to do in line with the sustainable development and the issues of hazardous waste that are being generated. IQ Air Visual 2018 is a world quality report. Now, who compiles it is important. This is compiled by Greenpeace and takes into consideration the fine particulate matter of particulate matter size 2.5. 7 of the most 10 polluted cities of the world are in India. Only 3 of the top 10 cities are outside India. So since 7 are in India, 3 are only the ones which are outside. And those 3 are Faisalabad in Pakistan, Houghton in China and Lahore. So besides that, all the 7 cities are in India, of which Gurgaon, Ghaziabad and Faridabad are considered among the most polluted. So that's again important. Of the 3,000 cities which have been surveyed, it's believed that 64% of these cities have higher than the exposure guideline being given by WHO. So that's very important to take into consideration. India Cooling Action Plan. Now, who released this plan? So ministries, as we say, are always important. So Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change released this plan. The idea is to reduce the emission and provide thermal comfort to the citizens of the country. It's a 20-year plan which aims to reduce 30% for the cooling requirement, energy efficiency, and bring in more energy efficient housing, mainly for the Awas scheme when we talk about, and also reduce the ozone depleting hydrocarbons, which are the hydrochlorofluorocarbons being released into the atmosphere. Global Chemical Outlook 2 is another report which is important. Now, it was an idea to check out the chemical and the hazardous waste which are being generated since 2006 under the UN Global Program, which is known as the Strategic Approach to International Chemical Management. And this aims to be achieved by 2020. You have a globally harmonized system for classifying those in around 120 countries of the world. Countries have still lagged on various pollution related transfer registers that are being maintained. So those are some of the important aspects. And the next important is the Global Environment Outlook 2019 being released by UN Environment Program. Now this is important because here India aims to be in the light, considering that if this is being checked, India could reduce the cost of nearly $3 trillion, which would be spent on the healthcare because of the climate change, if the climate change rises more than 1.5 degrees Celsius. So that's one of the aspects. Again, you have the target to achieve the lowering emission intensity of the GDP by 33 to 35% by 2030. So that's another objective that has to be met here. And finally, the Climate Vulnerability Index. Now, this index studies 12 Himalayan states led down by DST, that's Department of Science and Technology. So the 12 states which have been covered are here. It's ranging from 0 to 1. 1 means highly vulnerable, 0 means least vulnerable. So Assam and Mizoram are considered most vulnerable, mainly in lines of climate change, low per capita income, deforestation. And there are 8 parameters which are considered. Again, the most important question for your MCQ: which of the following is not a indicator of the vulnerability, climate vulnerability index being given? So these are the 8 parameters which are there, and of which area under slope of more than 30% is one of the major aspects. So here you could have 50%, 60% as one of the values that could be changed. Again, in Nagaland, the major issue is loss of forest area. Similarly, in Arunachal Pradesh, low female literacy rate and higher percentage of population below poverty line is another major issue. So with this, we cover the class for today. We'll be taking a series of expected questions in the upcoming months for 2019, covering most of the topics from 2018 and the first half of 2019. So stay tuned for further updates. Have a wonderful day ahead.